Hello, my name is Jim Wendler, the author and creator of 531. And today we're going to discuss why your search for the perfect program is probably a giant waste of time. Now, for those that do not know, I am the strength and conditioning coach at London High School. When I came to this idea, when I was watching one of our best players train, this was fairly recently. He has a multi-sport athlete. He has accolades in two different sports. One of the best players we've ever had here. Just an absolute physical and mental beast. And I realized that he does the exact same program as the kids who maybe don't play that much or don't play at all. Now, I was wondering, well, if the program is the same, then why is he so much better than everyone else? So today we're gonna discuss the reasons why and what you can and cannot control. Now remember, we're going to use football and training as an analogy, but it probably will apply to every area of life. First, let's discuss the things that you can't control. The most obvious thing is genetics. We're all born different. Get over it. This is in every area of life, not just sports. Now, we see it in sports because of all the television coverage and the popularity. If you are born a runt, blame your parents, okay? But do so for about an hour and then put on your big boy pants and realize that it's on you. The best advice I ever heard, a young man asked a coach how to increase his vertical jump, and the coach responded, get new parents. The bottom line is you have no control over your genetics. The next thing that you can control is your background. At a very early age, if you're exposed to sports, physical training or physical activity, like construction or farming, you're gonna have a very huge leg up on other kids. This is very similar to learning a foreign language. The earlier that you're exposed to it, the better off you're gonna be. Now, you have no control over this. However, if you are a parent, you are responsible for your child's physical health. The final thing that you can't control is what I call the X factor, and this is very hard to quantify. It's part genetics and part background. Some kids just have natural leadership ability. They have the swagger, they have the confidence, or maybe they just understand the sport better. Now, as a coach and parent, it's very easy to see a kid who's been emotionally and physically beaten down. Maybe they lack guidance also, or they lack a positive male role model. Again, this is very hard to quantify, but it is important. Now remember, you have no control over this unless you are a parent. All right, enough with the doom and gloom. If you lack great genetics, background, or X factor, here are some things that you can do and you have complete control over. Now, some of you may have to do more or less than others, just depends on who you are, but luckily the choice is yours. So here we go. Number one is diet. It doesn't matter what diet you choose as long as there's some common sense and something that appeals to you. Go for about 90 to 95% compliance. Rest and sleep. Make sure you're getting enough each day. Most importantly, stay off your phones. Also, stay off social media as much as possible. Make sure you're consistent with your training. Like your diet, we're looking for about 90 to 95% compliance. Attitude and effort. I've said this a million times, but attitude and effort requires no talent. Have great attitude every day when you wake up, when you go to training, when you go to school, whatever you're doing. Go to work, great attitude, great effort. Your daily habits, very easy to do. Wake up early and get your stuff done. I almost said a bad word there. Get your things done. Personally, every day, I try to read, write, and train. If I do those three things, I'm generally a better person for it. Be proactive with your hardships, with your weaknesses, or any problems that come towards you. Address them head on and make sure your shoulders are square. That's from Jordan Peterson, I believe. Be okay with who you are, but never ever be satisfied. Self-improvement begets confidence. Let's see here. Develop self-esteem through hard physical mental challenges. You don't need a bunch of people telling you how great you are if you've never really done anything. So challenge yourself all the time. That's how you improve your self-esteem. Have a strong moral code. I don't care really what it is, as long as you have a code, you stick with it, and you stick with it when times are tough. You may not like it at some point, but in the long run, you'll feel better about yourself. Be okay with failure. Long-term success is often riddled with short-term failures. get over it, and get back on the horse. Have goals, but more importantly, have an action plan for those goals. So let's say, for example, you want to bench 300 pounds. That's great. Go ahead and write it down. But what's more important is that you have like daily and weekly actions that will help you get to 300 pounds. Social life. You ready for this one? Get one. Surround yourself with good people. Surround yourself with people who have the same basic morals and ideals as you have. Don't hang out with a bunch of losers. I want to reiterate this. It is not cool to be weak and stupid. Relationships, your significant other. Make sure she is supportive of who you are and what you're trying to accomplish, and make sure she has the same drive as you do. Maybe not towards the same things, but to something in her life. Make sure she has her own life. And please God, stay away from anyone who loves drama, who loves fighting, who loves nagging, who is still at the teat of their parents. Get the hell out of that relationship right now. Be your own leader. Have super high expectations, super high standards, and don't be dragged down by the turds. And finally, you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to be a choir boy. In fact, the world needs more dangerous men with a strong moral code. All right, let's wrap all this up. Now listen, doing DK Metcalf's or Aaron Donald's or Barry Sanders' workout is not going to turn you into them. And conversely, the reason why DK Metcalf or Aaron Donald or Barry Sanders is so good is not because of some secret program, secret exercise, secret movements, or anything like that. That doesn't mean you can't get some inspiration or some ideas or that these guys' workouts are bad or good. There's no secret movements, exercises, or programs out there. If you're 5'10", 145 pounds, there's not some secret thing that you're going to do that's going to turn you to a 6'5", 265-pound shredded monster with a 42-inch vertical jump. Stop looking for this and start doing. Start being aggressive. Start being a man of action. As long as your training is balanced, is progressive, is consistent, is rooted in some kind of common sense, you're going to be fine. Do the little things that we talked about earlier in this video, do them with the discipline, with rage, with consistency, and with purpose. Now, this is not going to guarantee that you're going to go to the NFL. Far from it. But it's going to guarantee that you're going to be a whole lot better than you are today. And more importantly, you're going to be a leader and you're going to be an example. So this is Jim Wendler letting you all know that you don't have to be an All-American to make a huge difference.